choice and turn it up.
What's up? It's John Party.
Hey, what's up? It's Miller.
Hey, everyone. I'm Carrie Underwood.
All right.
Go Country 105.
Team, but I was hell on wheels with a full head of steam when Coach put me in. And I'm still proud of that hit. I was the last resort to go to prom with the queen. Thanks to an ex-boyfriend.
See, who are you?
No, I didn't get them. But I still felt like a king.
First Bible that his Don Williams bought. That first fish catching Zed Cole 33. Well, that might not mean much to you, but it does to me.
Country 105. That was Luke Combs and Eric Church with "Does to Me."
Mm-hmm.
I think there's a trend going on these days with country artists announcing their fatherhood by surprise.
There has been a lot of that lately.
So Morgan Wallen announced that he was a father on Monday,
yeah.
And then yesterday Tucker Beathard announced that he actually has a 2-year-old girl,
surprise,
named Sage.
Yes.
And it's funny that they make it like a big announcement. I don't know.
Yeah.
What the purpose is for that, but
I don't get it.
Like, hello world, by the way, you know, I've got a 2-year-old daughter, but, and obviously he is not with the mother, he's got a girlfriend,
right?
He's only 24.
Young.
So he had the girl, baby girl named Sage when he was 22 years old, but
wow.
You know, things happened, but
yeah.
I said it was a blessing, I guess, when he found out about his whatever girlfriend's quote-unquote pregnancy.
Right.
He was also in the middle of leaving his record label, so it was like the world was kind of crashing down. It's a lot
happening.
A lot
going
on when you're 22, but he saw it as a blessing, obviously, and now he's doing quite well. So.
It's funny. I wonder if he heard, after Morgan Wallen made the announcement, I wonder if that's when he was like, you know what? I'm going to let everyone know now.
It seems like, yeah. It's funny how it works. I'm, you know, be curious to see what else happens this week. Hopefully Adam doesn't surprise us at all. I knew you were going to come
Tim,
in.
Hopefully, I have something to tell you.
I've got something to tell you. I've got three cats at home that I've never told anybody about.
That's more appropriate.
Are you a cat guy? We should talk about that.
We'll
talk about it. This is kind of cool, actually. Since mid-March, when the lockdown started, almost all genres of music had a decrease in streaming on streaming platforms, except country music.
Mm-hmm.
11% increase on streaming platforms.
Yep.
I think the United States likes to turn to country music in a time of need.
I mean, it's happy. It just makes you feel good.
Or it isn't, and it makes you, you know, appreciate what's going on in the world. Like, that's
okay, you got to do
the breakup songs. That's what it's all about.
But you may sound happy.
No, they don't.
I think they do.
Oh, my goodness.
They put a smile on my face.
We are definitely... I'm not surprised. We're definitely talking about this.
No,
great, because I got to pick your brain about this. How do the breakup song?
I don't know. Just, again, the beat.
All right. We're going to talk about
my toast for a breakup.
I'm going to play, for those of you at home so you can hear me, I'm going to play Alan Jackson's So You Don't Have to Love Me Anymore for Adam after we go to commercial, and then you can tell me if you think it's a happy beat.
Right, we have a box of tissues here.
Listen to it.
I may need it.
Right now, music from Lenko. This is a happy one with What I See on Go Country 105.
What you see is an exercise. I see a road that goes back in time. The high school glory and all of those stories I stretch from time to time. Just might happen past midnight in a Sonic parking lot. What you see is a real sharp curve. I see a real hard lesson learned. I walked away from that without the scratches Lord knows I deserve. What you see are some stars and stripes. I see boys that ain't afraid to fight for the real white and blues for me and you.
So, yeah.
Country 105.